Have you ever wondered about using shopping malls as memory palaces? Well, I get this question a lot, and there are three major reasons why they really suck as memory palaces most of the time for most people, and some good reasons to change how you might use them that make it super simple and fun. So all that's coming right up. Hey there, this is Anthony Metivier from magneticmemorymethod.com, where we help mature learners unlock the full powers of their memory and take mental adventures so they can learn and remember massive amounts of information very, very quickly, whether it's passwords or foreign language vocabulary and phrases or complex terminology so you can be an expert in your profession. We take care of it all at magneticmemorymethod.com. So if you're new here, get started now by hitting thumbs up, getting subscribed, hitting that little bell icon, and joining us on the next live stream that we do. And we have some good ones, some great sessions together with the Magnetic Memory Method community and familia, as Adolfo likes to say. Now, I get lots and lots of questions about using shopping malls, and it's a great idea in principle because you are able to have this giant place that you can wander through in your mind and not run out of space. The problem is it's a giant space, and it can be very, very difficult to navigate and use some of the principles that are so useful for making memory techniques like the memory palace work. Because the reality is that ultimately smaller spaces tend to be better for learning projects, large learning projects, because of the role of recall rehearsal. Because you need to and want to use these small sets of information so that it's actually manageable to use recall rehearsal, and so you're not overwhelmed by massive amounts that you never get to the end of recall rehearsal. So that's something to keep in mind. Massive space does not mean massive memorization. Rather, a series of small spaces gathered together intelligently and well leads to much, much more memorization because you can break it down and work in small bits of space that have, say, 10 stations per memory palace and really get it through into your long-term memory quickly. Whereas if you've got hundreds of stations in a massive memory palace, then you've got to go through hundreds of stations and you can't use the tools of recall rehearsal and the patterns that enable you to go through it quickly. So that's one major problem with shopping malls. Another major problem with shopping malls is that it's very easy to cross your own path, up escalators, down escalators, oh, there's a fountain, and then there's a roller coaster ride, and oh, Santa Claus is over there during a certain season, but now he's not there, and so on. So there's just endless points of confusion. It's very, very difficult to create proper and effective linear journeys. And the longer the journey is, then the more you have to concentrate on what comes next. Right? So if you can break it down into component parts, then shopping malls can work. But the more that you try to extend this super long journey, the more you have to manage mentally, which means the more mental energy you have to spend, which means more energy spent on the memory palace and less energy spent on using the memory palace to get information into long-term memory. So it's just like common sense to make it manageable. And what is manageable is something that's measurable. And what's measurable is typically something that you can just hold in the palm of your mind, so to speak. So keep it small. And then along these lines, another sort of issue is that they're all contained in this singular space, right? All these stores, they're all together. And so then your temptation is to use them all together. And this is the third major problem, is that you're then going from store to store to store to store to fountain to the place where Santa Claus is and so forth, and you're gathering like bits of information in one mega memory palace when you actually don't need to work that way, and it's not necessarily advantageous to work that way, although this is all relative to your actual level of skill and what the nature of the information is. But if you think about this, and you break it down and you just work with individual stores inside of malls and only the individual stores that have any meaning for you. So for me, it would just be bookstores and maybe the odd skateboard store or something that I'm interested in a mall, the movie theater or something like this, something that's meaningful inside of there. Well, then you can just think about it as a small set for very, very concentrated memory tasks. So 10 vocabulary words, 10 phrases, whatever the case may be, well, let's organize them in a particular way so they make sense to have in Dymox at Chermside here in Brisbane, for example, right? And we could do that. And then we can have a bridging figure in there that works really well. And we don't then need to go into the clothing store that's next to it, which I've never really paid any particular attention to because it doesn't have any clothes that interest me. And, you know, I'm not just gonna create a memory palace out of it for memory palace creation sake, even though, you know, that's not a bad idea, it's not a bad policy. But the problem is that I have no particular interest in the clothes in that store. Now, if my wife were to show me a nice little dress in there and I'd be, well, you know, you see what I'm saying, then it becomes more real to the brain and then it's much more likely to actually get used and be useful, and we can chart it out, scope it out, and so forth. And when that day comes, then that day comes. If I'm really hard pressed for memory palaces, which I rarely am, then I could actually go and say, hey, would you mind trying on that dress in this store? Then note the name of the store beside Dymox and go from there. It's just that simple. And now that I'm thinking about it, there's actually a shoe store beside Dymox, directly beside there. And then there's the store that I'm thinking about. And so this is the thing. You've got a lot to organize mentally to work with shopping malls, and it's pretty easy to actually forget the direct relationship of different stores along a row where there's probably, in this particular case, a dozen or more shops just along that line, and there may be a corridor that breaks them or not. I don't know. I really don't like shopping malls myself. I try to avoid them if I can, but sometimes we go to them because we just got to go get something at them and so forth. So if they work for you, great. But if you're struggling to get traction with a memory palace, probably at least some of these three reasons are why. And the ultimate solution is just to be selective, be zero targeted and focused in on the stores that actually mean something to you, and then find good reasons, compelling reasons, to add more stores that can be meaningful for you, and then just go from there. And you don't have to have it all. If you're willing to let some of it go, then what you have becomes more precious, more useful, and more likely to be used. So I hope this helped you out with your memory palace creation. If you don't know how to make a memory palace properly, or you haven't taken the free Magnetic Memory Method course, go to magneticmemorymethod.com/YT. Grab it. It's got a couple of PDFs, three in total. It's got four videos. It walks you through creating them, making sure they're well formed strategically, so you actually use them, hit the ground running, and can direct them at major learning topics. You'll really, really enjoy the course, I'm sure. And if not, it was free. So that's at magneticmemorymethod.com/YT. And free stuff like that you won't find in any shopping mall. So come on in, get what you need, and we'll talk to you real soon. Thanks for watching this channel. Hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button if you'd like more like this, and let me know down in the comments your experiences with using large mega memory palaces. And there's another video about mega memory palaces at the Sydney Opera House that you can check out for some mnemonic examples of, Sydney Opera House in Chinese. So check that out, and thanks again for watching. Till we have a chance to speak again, thumbs up, get subscribed, and keep yourself magnetic.